الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. كيف حالكم؟ كيف أمسيتم؟ أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله والحمد لله، لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، وهو على كل شيء قدير. رب أسألك خير ما في هذه الليلة وخير ما بعدها، رب أعوذ بك من شر ما في هذه الليلة ومن شر ما بعدها، رب أعوذ بك من الكسل وسوء الكبر، رب أعوذ بك من عذاب في النار ومن عذاب في القبر. بسم الله الذي لا إله سواه، الواحد الأحد، الفرد الصمد، الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفواً أحد، والحمد لله أبداً سرمدا، حمداً يليق بجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه وجزيل نعمائه، والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المجتبى المصطفى الصادق الأمين الرسول المبين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آله الطاهرين الطيبين وأصحابه الغر الميامين والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، اللهم اجعلنا منهم، آمين. On the journey back home, because life in this world and our homes and families in this world have a lot to do with the home that we are destined to journey towards. We came from a home and we live in a home and we are meant to go back home. Home is where you and I originated, where our father Adam and mother Hawa, Eve, originated. And that was Jannah, paradise, in the company of the divine, in the company of the source of love, of the source of life, of the source of peace. And then, because of some circumstances, we had to leave home. And we were told to leave home because we made a mistake. We did something wrong, improper, immoral, unjust, not beautiful, not godly, not sanctioned by the divine. And we had to leave home and to come to this earthly home. But we are given a chance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return home. We can come back home, and this time forever, if as individuals and as families and as societies and as a world, we strive, for we are meant to strive to prevent and to avoid the mistake and the type of mistake that first caused us to leave home. Do you want to go back home? Oh yes, I want to go home. I really miss home. But I cannot go home if I continue as an individual or as a family, continue to commit the same type of mistakes that first led me to leave home. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, as He spoke of the early genesis of man and the source of and the reason of sending man and the aim of sending man to earth, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً, I am going to set on earth a vicegerent, a steward. Though we made a mistake and we had to leave, that leaving Jannah was not after all degrading and humiliating. It was in the divine love and in the divine norm. It was a means by which to make us khulafa of His, vicegerents of his, stewards of his, representatives of his on earth. By manifesting in our lives the divine attributes in this world, and not do like when we were there, we held tight and fast to something transient because of our strong passion. We were in Jannah with the divine, and yet the divine commanded us not to approach such a tree. And we were in Jannah in his company. And because of our low gravitational pull of passion, we disobeyed. Disobedience does not harm God, it lowers us. It abases us. We are not worthy anymore as we were originally and naturally. We're not worthy anymore of divine presence. إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. But this Khalifa, when sent to earth, is going to achieve his or her Khilafa not without struggle. But there will be on earth animosity between that which is immoral, that which is evil, that which is devilish, that which is satanic, that which is low, and that which is noble and divine and beautiful and divine. For Allah Azza wa Jalla says, اِهْبِطَ مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ. Go down, both of you, both parties. Some enemies of others. This means in a beautiful, subtle way that our role on earth as individuals, as families, as societies, is one role in which we are to face hardships, difficulties, things that are against us, things uncomfortable, things that are hurtful. And of those things that are hurtful and painful are our passions, our drives, our individual drives. Those are more dangerous as enemies than a physical enemy. The drive inside of you and me that is negative, that is base, that is evil, that is deluding, that is arrogant, that is ostentatious, those drives are shaitan-like drives. When we entertain them at home, there will be conflicts unresolvable. At home, a father and a mother and a child and siblings, at work, wherever we work, in administration, in engineering, in politics, wherever we work, if we succumb to the drives inside of us, to the low passionate drives inside of us of arrogance and delusion and ostentation, we will not listen carefully to each other's concerns and pain and hurt. We will not be fair and just. We will not be kind and benevolent. We would do wrong, and we will be in pain in this world before even being in pain in the hereafter. So Allah Azza wa Jal says to you and to me, don't do the same mistakes as your parents in Jannah when they obeyed shaitan and caused them to leave Jannah. Ya bani Adam la yaftinannakum ash-shaytanu كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة. Oh, children of Adam, don't allow Shaitan to delude you as he deluded your parents and caused them to leave Jannah. لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة ينزع عنهما لباسهما ينزع عنهما لباسهما. He makes sure to remove from them both their garments. Their garments. Garments? What garments? Well, you can already, in a direct way, connect it to, yes, external humility. And we dress externally beautifully, but there is beauty in humility, in humbleness, in bashfulness, in haya. Shaitan wants to remove that garment external from you and me, both garments, and the garment internal. Internal garment, the garment of taqwa, the garment of God consciousness, the garment of internal beauty. He wants to make you and me inside ugly, not only outside. Exposition in a way that is excessive, external, is actually to the spiritual eye, wallahi al-azim, ugly. Wallahi al-azim, an eye of the heart, when it is innocent, when it is clean, it sees what others see externally beautiful because of exposure. It sees it qabih, ugly. But when the eye of the heart, when the qalb is not clean, when the qalb has not changed, the eye of the heart is clouded, it sees ugliness as beauty, and beauty as ugliness. Justice as injustice, and injustice as justice. Kindness and goodness as unkindness and evil. And it sees evil as kindness and goodness. It sees things upside down when the eye of the qalb is not properly cleansed. Don't allow shaitan, says Allah Azza wa Jal, to delude you in this world and to cause you never to be able to come back home. And to live in this world in homes, whether local homes, small homes, or the home of a neighborhood, or the home of a town, or the home of a society, or a home of a nation, or a home of the world, that is horrible to live in. Pain, restlessness, agony, fear, insecurity, anxiety, hopelessness, violence, all of that is a home that we live in because we did not care much about cleansing ourselves inside. A family is worth whatever it is worth, not because it is rich, not because it is wealthy, not because it is powerful, but because internally it is beautiful. When I am inside ugly and externally attractive, whether in a physical sense, in a material sense, or in a religious sense, externally only, Allah Azza wa Jal, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَشْكَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ. Verily, Allah is not interested in your shapes and forms and in the way you look outside. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah looks at your hearts, beautiful or ugly. And the road to God, the road home, ultimate home, from this home is a road that is crossed and walked not with the legs of my body, but with the legs and wings of my heart. What does that mean? If my heart changes positively, dynamically, positively, from ugly to beautiful to more beautiful, from immoral to moral, from moral to divine, then I am walking forward towards home and towards Allah Azza wa Jal. When internally my qalb and the state of my qalb, instead of going forward, instead of marching forward, instead of being transformed internally, positively, instead of doing that, then I walk backwards. Or I don't move at all internally. I'm still the same person internally as I was 25 years ago. I still am the person who holds the same emotions and feelings the same way as I was 25 years ago. I'm still the same greedy person I was 25 years ago. I'm still the same angry, intolerant person I was 25 years ago. I'm still the same arrogant, deluded, ostentatious person I was 10 years ago or even a month ago. There is no forward change. I am not going home. And that reverberates and that reflects in my life, at home, in this world, in my neighborhood, in this world, in my society and nation, in this world. For we will get home, that home, the way we lived in this home. كل امرئ يموت على ما عاش عليه ويبعث على ما مات عليه, as a text in our Islamic tradition teaches, some say it is a prophetic text, everyone shall die the way he or she lived and shall be resurrected the way he or she died. My dear sisters and brothers, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala that those who will come home to the final home in His divine company, they will enjoy His divine company only if they came to Him with a heart that is healthy and sane and beautiful. The prayer of our father Abraham alayhi salam, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Oh, dear God, do not cause me to be despised on the day when nothing will be of any avail to anyone except the one who comes to you, the journey home, comes to you with a heart that is beautiful, that is healthy, that is sane. Sayyidi Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, the great saint of Islam, great scholar and saint of Islam, said rahimahullah ta'ala, and I love to remind myself of this teaching and to remind my brothers and sisters, it is never too often to cite it. It's never too often to cite it. He said to you and to me, to the teachers, to the scholars, to the students, to the activists, to the dua, to everyone, he says to you and to me, boy, ya ghulam. Everyone for him was a little boy. He was 91 years of age when he died. Alayhi ridwanullah, a great scholar and a beautiful heart. He said, rahimahullah ta'ala, mali araka fi qiyamin wa qu'udin wa ruku'in wa sujudin وتعب وسهر ونصب وقلبك لم يبرح من مكانه ولم يتحول عن عادته. Why do I see you standing, kneeling, prostrating, standing up nights in vigils, in fatigues, in sleeplessness, working hard, yet your heart is yet to move from its place and is yet to change its habits. You have gone nowhere in your quest of the divine. You have gone really nowhere when your heart has gone nowhere, has not transformed, has not changed in your orientation towards the divine. My dear sisters and brothers, this world is not, we are in this world not to be, well, the purpose to be in this world is not to be powerful and wealthy. It could happen, but that's not our aim. Our aim is not to be wealthy and powerful. Our aim is to be beautiful, a beautiful heart, a world run with beautiful values by beautiful hearts is more likely to endure happily than a world run with wealth and power and without values. Winning a battle of wealth or power at the expense of values is not worth it. Is not worth it. A home built in this world at the expense of tawheed, at the expense of beautiful morals, of akhlaq, at the expense of internal beauty is not worth it. I'd rather lose preserving my values, my moral values, my beauty, than win and giving up my values and my moral beauty. My dear sisters and brothers, our families, our societies, as our dear brother has, Congressman has said, Hafizahullah, we are to contribute to this society, our society, and to this world in this way. We must be and continue to be the moral fiber of this world. We must continue to be and strive to be the tawheedi fiber of this world, even if the road is longer, but it is surer, and the outcome is much more beautiful than without it. Wa sallallahu wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.